We're going to connect these two side incisions. Together. Flap here is thicker, so you need a good sharp instrument to incise that. So you just going to remove your blade from the bone so that you don't make additional incisions in the skin. Cotton patties soaked in adrenaline here would really be very helpful. So now we feed most part of it, and you see now as we proceed further, there is a hump coming, so it should be very, if you hurry it here, and you're going to tear the flap from here. So this is the hump that you should notice at the start of surgery, and you have to be careful. We're trying to be careful, there's a little band here. I'm putting up. So now you can see the flap nicely being lifted off the bone. We have so far just used a single cotton patty. Really changes your view. So gradually we are advancing it. Maybe this is the trouble spot. We have a difficulty raising the flap here because it is here, isn't it? See? You might sometimes need scissors here. With some patients, you will end up having a surgery. Good results, and the total surgical times will also improve. So this patient has a perforation very close to the interior edge of the annulus, so we would expect that the moment we get near, there are chances that we may actually go directly into the middle ear. So we will be careful while we reach this part. So here is the annulus probably coming in. And we need to see the flap from here. So now you see the whole flap has been nicely elevated. Here I was just showing you. Here is the chorda tympani. We have identified it. And we have opened the middle ear before the right underneath it. You can see here this is the annulus. So we have to be careful lifting the annulus from the groove. It can get torn away very easily. So I will use a side knife now to lift the rest part of the flap, I think that lifting the annulus from its bony groove gets easier using this side knife. Because now you see, you can just see the groove getting cleared off. You have a little flap resistance here. So you can clear that. And now, we are going to gently teasing it off the chorda tympani as well. And now you would be able to. Thank you. the whole system is working, so there's no need for any ossicular reconstruction in this case. All we need to do is just put in a good graft that won't go away and finish this case. All this is the area of the where the ligaments get attached and the chorda tympani is coming. Actually, the chorda tympani comes from here, goes here behind the two ossicles, and then somewhere here it exits out. And now we are going to put our tympanometer flap back again and see how the graft looks. Do we really need a perichondrial graft, or we would be doing good without it? So we need, this is a gap here. Thank you.